40:38. A believer from the house of Pharaoh, who had kept his faith to himself, said, "Will you kill a man because he says, 'My Lord is Allah,' when he has brought you clear signs from his Lord?"
So as not to take this verse or surah out of context, we'll review it at the end of the chapter.
Tabari and Ishaq. Hamza bin Abdul Muttalib came with his bow slung over his shoulder. He was a great huntsman and used to go out for game with his bow and arrows. When he came back from the hunt, he would not go back to his family until he had circumambulated the Kaaba. He was the strongest man of the Quraysh. A woman rose up and said, "If only you had seen what your nephew Muhammad had to endure just now before you came." Abu Jahl spoke to him offensively. Hamza was carried away by fury, as it was Allah's will to honor him in this way.
In Islam, it's an honor to be furious.
He went off quickly, not stopping to speak to anyone. Instead of circumambulating the Kaaba, he was ready to attack Abu Jahl when he saw him. When he entered the mosque...
This is a reminder that the Kaaba was a pagan mosque, or place of prostration, before it was the center of Islamic worship. Further, the prostration prayer, Islam's signature move, preceded the Quran.
He saw him sitting among the people. Hamza raised his bow and gave Abu a blow which split his head open in an ugly way. He said, "Do you insult him when I am a member of his religion? Hit me back if you can."
Before Islam, Hamza hunted animals for food. After Islam, he hunted humans for his god. While he was but a lone terrorist with a bow, he established the pattern that would soon rock the world. The change did not escape notice.
Tabari and Ishaq. Hamza's Islam was complete. He followed the Prophet's every command. The Quraysh recognized that, by Hamza's acceptance of Islam, Muhammad had been made strong. Hamza would protect him.
Violence made a man's Islam complete, and a man made a prophet strong.
Ishaq and Tabari. The first to recite the Quran aloud in Mecca after the apostle was Abdallah bin Mas'ud. On the day the companions of the Prophet were assembled together,
all five of them,
and remarked, "The Quraysh have never heard this Quran recited aloud to them. Who will make them listen to it?"
This is an astonishing admission. Muhammad is 50 years old and a decade into his mission. Mecca is a tiny place, clustered around a minuscule shrine. 80 surahs have been revealed, 75% of the Quran, yet...
The Quraysh have never heard this Quran recited aloud to them.
Then what, pray tell, was the source of the war of words between Muhammad and his critics? If Muhammad wasn't preaching God's word, what on earth was he saying that was so obnoxious?
Abdallah bin Mas'ud said, "I will." They said, "We fear what they will do to you. What we want is a man who has a clan who will protect him against them if they seek to harm him." He...
foolishly
replied, "Let me do it. Allah will protect me."
But alas, Allah was never into the miracle business. Tabari didn't reference the surah Mas'ud elected to recite. Ishaq did. I was stunned to learn that it was the 55th.
Ar-Rahman.
The hadith claims Allah's protection, yet Mas'ud was singing Ar-Rahman's praises. It's little wonder the Meccans were up in arms. Muhammad was venerating Allah's house, their Kaaba, but he was claiming that it belonged to a rival moon god.
Ishaq. The next day, Ibn Mas'ud went to the Kaaba in the late morning when the Quraysh were gathering there in groups. He turned toward them as he recited, in Quran 55, verse 1, "Ar-Rahman bestowed the Quran. He created man. He taught man eloquent speech and intelligence. The sun and moon are made punctual, following courses. They revolve to a computation."
According to the Islamic God, the sun moves, not the earth.
Ar-Rahman created the herbs, or stars, and the trees, all of which prostrate themselves.
Mas'ud proudly proclaimed,
"He created man of fermented clay, dried tingling hard like earthenware, and created jinn from the white-hot flame of fire. How many favors of your Lord will you both deny?"
Ar-Rahman, like Allah, made man as one would distill alcohol.
Quran 55:19. He has set the two seas,
not seven,
in motion that flow side by side with a barrier between them that they cannot cross.
Wrong again.
How many favors of your Lord will you both deny?
How many lies must the dark spirit of Islam utter before Muslims deny him? The first Meccan Quran recital turned nasty with these words.
Quran 55:31. Soon we will dispose of you both, men and jinn, by applying our two armies. How many favors of your Lord will you both deny?
A second translation reads,
we shall soon be free to turn on you, O weary caravans.
Muhammad would soon prosper by raiding Meccan caravans.
Verse 35. There will be let loose on you both white-hot flames of fire and smoke that chokes, so that you will not be able to defend yourselves. How many favors of your Lord will you both deny?
A rockman makes jinn out of the same material he will use to torture men. That means the dark spirit of Islam intends to send his demons after us. Unless we forget, this spirit considers torture a favor. Masud continued to recite the
Ar-Rahman
Surah to the Meccans.
Quran 55, verse 41. The sinners will be seized by their forelock and feet. Which of the favors of your Lord will you then deny? This is the hell the sinners called a lie. They will go round and round between its fierce fires and boiling water. Which of the favors of your Lord will you then deny?
Apart from Satan, can you imagine any spirit suggesting that burning and scalding were favors? Having sickened the Quraysh with demonic torments, Masud teased them with decadence.
Quran 55:46. For him who lives in terror of his Lord are two gardens containing delights, shade, two fountains flowing, fruits in pairs, reclining on carpets lined with silk brocade, fruits hanging low. In them, virginal females with averted glances, desiring none but you, undeflowered by men or jinn. Is the reward of goodness aught but goodness?
Ar-Rahman has just labeled decadence good, and living in terror is the path to paradise.
Verse 62. And beside this, there are two other gardens, rich green in color from plentiful watering. In them will be two springs gushing forth, and fruits, and beautiful companion, virgins cloistered in pavilions, undefiled by men and jinn, reclining on green cushions and rich mattresses. Which of the favors of your Lord will you both deny?
I would have loved to have seen the reaction on the Meccans' faces as they listened to Muhammad's religious disciple recite this demonic message.
Ishaq and Tabari. The Meccans took notice of Masud. What on earth is this son of a slave's mother saying? Then they said, he is reciting some of what Muhammad has prayed.
Not recited, prayed. These fantasies represented Muhammad's cravings.
They rose up and began to hit him in the face.
So much for Allah's protection.
He continued to recite as much as Allah willed that he should, and then he went back to his companions with the marks of their blows on his face. They said, this is what we feared would happen to you. But he replied, the enemies of God were never more despicable in my sight than they are now. If you wish, I will do the same thing to them tomorrow. They replied, no, you have done enough.
It's the cause and effect of Islam. The religion causes Muslims to hate everyone who isn't a Muslim. It's a condition that persists to this day. The Sirah follows this incriminating encounter with another. Muhammad was afraid to recite the Quran in public, so the Meccans eavesdropped outside his mud hut one night.
Ishaq, when they heard the Quran, they said, in mocking, our hearts are veiled. We do not understand what he is saying. There is a load in our ears. Then Allah revealed, and when you recite the Quran, we put between you and those who do not believe a hidden veil. They turn in aversion. In secret councils, the mockers say, they are following a man bewitched.
The next Ishaq segment is omitted by Tabari. I can only assume that the historian couldn't find a credible supporting tradition, or he had collected enough contrary hadiths to question its truth.
Ishaq. The Quraysh showed their enmity.